I have found every single argument for God fallacious. The most fundamental fallacy of all of them is the assumption that rhetoric proves actuality. But a fallacious argument does not mean that the conclusion is false. It only means that the conclusion does not follow the premises or that the premises are assumed without support. For example, the premises are the conclusion of another fallacious argument. So, for the sake of this argument, let's assume that there is a necessary first cause, and that cause is a mind powerful enough to have created a fine-tuned space-time. Let's assume that this mind sparked life within the universe right here on Earth, and provided us humans with sentient souls that grant us free will. Let's call this entity God. Let us further assume that the devil exists, an entity created by God who rebelled and wants to deceive us. I find, however, a disconnection between these conclusions and the Christian Bible, a Bible that has been falsified in every falsifiable aspect. If the Bible is the word of God, then either God is lying to us through the Bible, the special revelation, or he is lying to us through nation and evidence, the general revelation. So the Bible seems rather written or inspired by the devil. If God is all-knowing, all-powerful, all-loving, and wants us to be free, then he need not to be worshipped. While the devil can twist the word in order to deceive us, it would be the devil the one more interested in crafting the Bible than God himself. Or neither God nor the devil inspired the Bible. The Bible is just the word of man, passed on other traditions and other words of men, with a few original thoughts, such as rejection of a pantheon, just to make sense of their own lives. How can we know the Bible is not the word of the devil? How can we know the Bible is not the word of fallible men? Using the Bible to justify the Bible can easily be using the deceiver's words to justify his words.